Module 5, integrate content with the Power BI client APIs. Hello, I'm Peter Myers, the course developer.
And I'm Amit Shuster, product manager of Power BI Embedded Analytics.
In this video, we continue to describe the development methodology for embedding Power BI content, now with a focus on enhancing the end user experience.
Integrate and enhance embedded Power BI content with the Power BI client APIs. Our client API supports both JavaScript and TypeScript, but before that, let's go and see how it works. So what you can see here, this is the customer service insights sample environment. And you can see here the client application, where you have the left nav and the top action bar. On the right side, you can see the embedded report. And this report is separated by an iframe that separates the application code from the Power BI report and creates a separation. What you can do in order to communicate with this report, you can use the client APIs and use the bidirectional communication that the client APIs provide you to communicate between the application code and the report.
So let's now describe what's possible for you to do in your apps. The Power BI client APIs support many capabilities. User interactions can be natively supported by the report view.
So you will have all the interactions that you currently have in the Power BI service. So you can slice and dice, and you can highlight a report or drill through or drill up, drill down a visual.
And user interactions can also trigger subscribable events.
So Peter, here, like some of the events that I want to mention are the options to see what the user is clicking on. So you can listen to the visual clicked event or button clicked. And you can also listen to the page navigation event to see what page the user is currently viewing.
And there's also programmatic interaction.
So I can do things like set a filter or set a slicer and get the report in a specific state.
And then there's dynamic report layouts.
So with dynamic report layout, you can set different views and different screens. So for example, I can create a specific view for a tablet or a specific view for mobile.
And what about capturing and sharing bookmarks?
So bookmarks allow you to save the view of the report, and we allow you to capture the view on the fly and also apply saved views that are currently saved on the report.
And report visual creation and personalization.
We allow you to create report on the fly by using our report offering APIs, where you can create visuals and also modify them and personalize them as you need.
And lastly, embed token regeneration when tokens expire.
So in order to keep your user session always active, you will need to refresh the embed tokens that is currently using. And this can be done with the set access token method.
Let's now introduce the packages available to you.
First, we have the Power BI client package. This is our main package that supports both JavaScript and TypeScript and allow you to use the APIs that we talked about before and integrate Power BI into your apps. Second, we have the Power BI models package, which contains JavaScript and TypeScript object models. So whenever you need the contracts for the APIs that you're using, you should use the Power BI models. Then we have the Power BI report offering package. This package contains functionality that help you edit and create visuals on the fly. And this is an extension of the Power BI client library. And last, we have the Power BI client React package. This is a specific package for React that allow you to easily embed Power BI content in a React web application.
Consider that the client APIs can allow you to drive an in-context analytics workflow. Well, what does that mean? Let's show you by example.
First, the user navigates within the app to the place where you have the report embedded. Then, the app shows a report that is filtered to a specific view. Now, the user interactively filters the data in the report, so we can slice and dice the data. Then, when the user clicks on a button, he can perform an action, and the app responds by running some custom code that is part of the application code.
That sounds great. So how about we see how this works by an example from the Power BI Playground?
Great idea, Peter. Let me demonstrate this example in the Power BI Embedded Analytics Playground. Here in the Playground, I'm going to demonstrate to you the showcase of Go from Insights to Quick Action. I'll just go to the left nav and open the showcases and click on the first one. Go from Insight to Quick Action. Now you can see the Contoso app, where Contoso company wants to create a campaign with their customers. So the first thing I'm going to do is to use the slicers at the top to filter this report to show only the customers that have purchased in the last 7 days. So the report now shows me customers that purchased in the last 7 days. And the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the button at the right upper corner where you see create a campaign. When I clicked on this button, this ran a custom application code that exported the data from this table and also opened this dialog that I can now do additional level filtering before sending a coupon or sending a discount. So what I might choose to do is remove people from the list. So let's remove a few of them. And then I'm going to click on Send Coupon. Here, I can change the title and insert an additional message. And after that, click on Send. So what you just saw here, this is a way to integrate Power BI in your apps and get from insight to action and connect the Power BI report to your application.
Great. Well, in the next video, I'll demonstrate enhancing my app by adding client-side logic, specifically adding a client-side filter and also adding a context menu.